design of the 2018 Chevrolet Traverse is a big improvement over the previous generation of the big crossover. In my opinion, its face wears the newest iteration of the dual-shield Chevrolet corporate grille and features wide, trapezoidal headlight lenses. My tester had fog lights cleanly integrated into nacelles on the lower bumper area. A familial crease runs from the bottom of the Traverse's chin to the hood, equally bisecting the golden Chevy Bowtie. This design element is shared throughout the Chevy family, from the tiny Spark hatchback to the biggest Silverado HD pickup truck. From the side view, one might be forgiven for mistaking the new Traverse for a late model Ford Explorer. The head and taillights sweep onto the side design, and a sharp crease connects them through the doors. A forward-leaning C-pillar separates the rear passenger door glass from the cargo area. Third row side glass. These are all strong design elements, but the Explorer was there first. From the side view, one might be forgiven for mistaking the new Traverse for a late model Ford Explorer. Chevy says the Traverse was redesigned so that its profile looked more like its truck-based family members, the Tahoe and Suburban. True enough, there is some family resemblance. Some people even said, unprompted by yours truly, that they saw some Tahoe in this redesign. But the side view is one area where, for better or worse, the previous generation of the Traverse was more unique. The new design looks less feminine to my eye, but also less identifiable as a Traverse. From the rear, the hatched glass appears to wrap around the D-pillar thanks to some blackout trim. It's a good design trick. The hatch looks more upright than the previous Traverse, which results in decent cargo volume behind the third row. 23 cubic feet. Fold down the third row seats, and there's a plentiful 58.1 cubic feet to haul things. There's 98.2 cubic feet if you fold the second row captain's chairs. That's not quite minivan-sized cargo capacity, but it's close. Legroom for front occupants is 41 inches. Second row riders get 39 inches, and third row passengers get 33.5 inches. The second row slides forward, so there's the ability to divvy up legroom if needed, and the second row seats slide and tilt forward with ease to allow access to that third row. The interior design of the Traverse isn't just practical, it's attractive. The interior design of the Traverse isn't just practical, it's attractive. This may be the biggest improvement the new Traverse makes over its previous generation. The two-tone dashboard in my Traverse 3 LT was a clean, futuristic design with lots of soft touch surfaces. Its centerpiece was the 8-inch Chevrolet MyLink touchscreen infotainment system featuring navigation, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto connectivity, and 4G LTE Wi-Fi. The system's design was easy to master and easy to use while driving, thanks to big on-screen buttons combined with simple steering wheel controls and voice commands. I still give Chrysler Uconnect a slight edge in ease of use, but Chevrolet MyLink is catching up to it quickly. Seats were comfortable in the first and second rows for me. At 6'3", I was pretty cramped in the third row bench, which sat a little too low for comfort even when I moved the second row seats forward a couple of inches to make room for my knees. For young children, the third row should be fine.